All right, can you hear me out of this one? We have the worst administrators ever. All right, check. Okay, I'm in two, he's in one.
I've got...
You can hear?
I can hear you.
Okay, here, switch to mirror. Check. Check, I can hear...
I can't hear anything.
You can't hear me? Keep talking.
I can't hear you.
Okay, I can hear two, but two
I can hear you, one. Like, just from talking, but I can't
okay,
hear
two
you.
Two cannot hear one. Check. Check. Do you hear anything?
No.
Check. Do you have any idea what's going on?
Check.
I can hear you. Can you hear anything? Okay, check now.
Check. No. Check.
Hey, can we get an update on two? Hey, two still can't hear.
Check.
Hey, can you check the microphone real quick to make sure we can hear you? Yes, no.
Hey, are we getting this going? we're just going to have to go. It's fine.
Alright, I think they're picking you up.
Alright, do your thing.
Welcome to Hazlett High School tonight. We got Hazlett varsity volleyball team taking on DeWitt for the district playoffs. Score is currently 2-0 Hazlett. 2-1 Hazlett, sorry.
I know, okay. Yeah. Great kill. I can't see. Great kill there by Hazlett, and it is 3-1 Hazlett here early in the first set. Heather Holton back to serve. And great kill by Hazlett. It is 4-1.
Great kill by senior Sarah.
Holton still serving. DeWitt sets it up. And it's blocked. And another great point by Hazlett. DeWitt tried to get something going with a nice little pass around, but they could not get the spike down. Holton's still
job.
Serving.
Heather does a great job on the front line, blocking yeah. down all their passes.
Definitely. DeWitt with the kill.
Barely gets the floor there.
Some great volleyball here in the early stages. Good passing. Number 14, Abby Nakfour, back for DeWitt. They're down 2-5. Froner tries to get the kill just a tad bit deep, and that is a point for DeWitt.
A little too much pepper on that one, Andy.
That's for sure. Brassington sets it up. Softly over the net. Here comes DeWitt. And a nice hit there by number 13, Lexi Nordman.
A little too much for number 3, Courtney Brassington, to handle. She wasn't quite able to get underneath that.
Nakfour back to serve again. DeWitt coming back into this first set a little bit. Corner with some finesse. A great block there. I believe that was Trosco and Kroner up there. And looks like we'll have number 4, Allison Rich, back to serve. Hazlett up 6-4 in the early going.
Rich for Libro today.
Number 9, Maria Moss, tried to get the spike down, but it was rejected by the net. Rich back to serve again for the Vikings, up 7-4. Nice kill there by number 13,
Holden,
Lexi Nordman.
Holden just couldn't get there in time.
She is imposing her will her in the early going. Number 12, Carly Steve, back to serve. DeWitt sets it up. Nice rally going on here. Trosco, nice hit.
Oh, power
DeWitt
hit.
Manages to save it. Nice
DeWitt
job.
DeWitt barely gets it over. They're happy for that one.
Hazlett needs to do something with it here.
Hazlett in control on
and
this side. They get it
point
in.
Hazlett, great job there by the Vikings to stick with it and come out on top.
Hazlett really needs to capitalize on those plays.
So we got some substitutions. Number 8, Megan Mowat, into the game. She's back to serve.
It's an interesting substitution as Megan Mowat is only a sophomore.
Nice serve. Nice set here. Rich and then Holton.
With the spike. Power spike. DeWitt sets it high.
Couldn't get the spike down. I think someone maybe touched the net on that one.
It looks like it.
DeWitt point. 8-6 Hazlett. McKenna Ott with a great kill. And it is now 9-6 Hazlitt.
You can tell there's a lot of power behind that one.
Yeah, they have some nice tall
Someone's
girls.
Someone's been in the weight room this summer. And Hazlitt hits a little too far off to the side.
Nice job by DeWitt.
That one.
Hazlitt definitely seems to have the height advantage out there.
As of right now, DeWitt only having number 12, Carly Stevie, as the tallest person.
Number 5, Julia Rios to serve. Here's Odd again. Nice block by DeWitt. Hazlitt gets it around Holton. Nice diving save there, and they could not save it, though. It is Hazlitt's point. It is now 10-7.
Got to commend the effort on DeWitt's
That
side.
Was a great diving diving try there.
Great attempt.
McKenna Ott back to serve. Nice and low. Great serve.
Hazlitt's just on a roll right now. They seem to be knowing what they're doing.
It's about as easy as a point you can get at for Hazlitt.
Hazlitt doesn't want anything else right now. A
little far. So after that great serve, she comes back with an error, and it was 11-8 Hazlitt. DeWitt's number 6, Caitlin Setter. Great name for a volleyball player, back to serve.
It's funny she's serving, not setting.
Yeah. What do you know?
A little irony right there.
Nice kill there by Hazlitt. Looks like we'll get some more substitutions. Oh, actually, never mind. Hazlitt did not kill that. That is my fault. Number 6, Setter, back to serve again.
Rich with the set.
Oh. Nice save there by King.
Barely gets it over the net on the one-handed.
That is out on the try. Oh, and the DeWitt did not like that call. But they're going to stick with it. 12-9 Hazlitt. Back to serve is Courtney Brassington, number 3. DeWitt definitely keeps that ball high up in the air. Oh,
yeah,
two
a little
Hazlitt
bit of miscommunication right
converge
there.
Converge on the ball, and it is out of bounds.
Looks like Rich might have taken a hit to the face there.
She's tough. She's shaking it off. Number
That's
8.
A true player. You
Gina
couldn't ask for
Valona.
More on a team.
Back to serve. Brassington with the set for Holton.
Holton with a powerful spike. Allison with the pass. Kroner spike. It comes right back. DeWitt can't. Oh, they
Big
managed to
here.
Save it.
Still going. Rich is up for Holton.
They
Still
are just
going.
Pounding on DeWitt right now with these hits.
Oh,
and Hazlitt
nice misdirection.
So composed.
And DeWitt finally wins the point to make it 12-11. They are right in the set, right with Hazlitt. That was a fantastic point. DeWitt managed to pull it out in the end.
Great job by DeWitt to stay with it.
Number 8, Valona, back to serve after some great defense on that last point. Hazlitt just gets it back over after a little miscommunication.
Spike set by Ott.
Oh, great block by the Viking front line. That was a key point to get momentum back on the Viking side. It is 13-11. Holton back to serve. Trosko with a powerful hit, returned by Valona.
Trosko with the set in front with the spike.
Number 12, Stevie with a powerful hit, could not be blocked by the Vikings. Falls harmlessly on their own side, and it is 13-12 to Hazlitt.
I'll be honest with you right now, Andy. I didn't think the game was going to be this close. I thought Hazlitt was going to blow them out of the water first set.
Very exciting here in the early going. Hazlitt won their last meeting. Yeah, go ahead.
First time Hazlitt DeWitt met this year. They won three sets to one.
Yeah, it was quite
the
performance
match
by the Vikings. Point there for Hazlitt. Rich back to serve. She sets up, lets it fly. DeWitt is keeping the ball very high. Nice hit there. That's like number 13. Lexi Nordman with a nice hit.
Holton not able to get to it.
Nope. Good placement by DeWitt on that one. Here's number 12 Carly Steve back to serve. Floats it over.
Rich falls
up
down
for McKenna
it.
Ott. Nice powerful hit.
Oh.
And
the DeWitt player comes and almost knocks
over,
us over.
She is.
There's the effort
the
I
effort
like to
was
see.
Great. And we almost went down over here, folks.
That just got my adrenaline racing.
That was terrifying, really.
Nothing gets the adrenaline racing like a player almost hitting you.
15-13 has a close set here. Megan Mowen back to serve.
Best seats in the house here.
There's a true speech right there, Tyler. Oh, great block by Hazlitt. DeWitt still keeps it going. Here's Rich up for Trosco.
Oh,
it's blocked. Still keeps
save.
The
Hits
point going.
That.
There's been some great blocks here in this point. Up for DeWitt.
The block.
Another block.
DeWitt just trying to get it over.
And, wow, great defense by the Viking front line. That was a key point.
Hazz was very persistent on that last drive and really paid off for him there with the point. Mode serving.
Oh, little finesse there by number 13, Lexi Nordman.
Mode not able to
point.
Handle it.
I think the Vikings were expecting a little more out of that one, wouldn't you say, Tyler?
I would agree.
Little drop shot gets it down.
The finesse can win it for you. It's not all about power.
Maria Moss served, and looks like a block by DeWitt. Has it, keeps it up. DeWitt's got a chance to make something happen here. And it is
DeWitt's
in.
Point.
Just in. That was great placement on that kill.
Great call by the line judge there.
That was a close one. Ross again. Oh, nice kill there. I think that was McKenna Ott, maybe. Maybe it was Trosco. Anyway, Trosco back to serve. 17-15 as this first set is winding down.
Trosco with the
and
long
Trosco
serve.
A little too much as that serve is out.
17-15 has it.
16-17. 16, Tyler.
My apologies, I did not count the last point.
I forgive you for one. I don't know about our viewers. Here comes number
five. All my viewers
five.
Out there, I like to apologize.
Julia Rios serves.
Always have a place for me in your
Mowen
heart.
Mowen sets it for Trosco. It is in the net, and we have a tied first set here, folks.
This game's going to end up being a nail-biter. I would not be surprised to see a five-set match.
That sure would be exciting here in the playoffs.
It's anybody's game.
Here's Holton, nice little spin on that one. DeWitt sets it up. Number four, Slater tried to get it over, and it is just out as DeWitt takes the lead here in the early going. It is 18-17.
DeWitt really seems to have the momentum right now.
Julia Rios back to serve. Here's Holton. DeWitt. Quick exchange here in the early going on this point. McKenna Ott pushes it down. Here comes DeWitt. It is
DeWitt
in the net.
Get it over.
Number four, Slater, could not quite get that ball over. And we have another tie ball game here. Another tied set. Here's McKenna Ott back to serve.
My prediction is first one to get to 20 is going to win the match. I think these next 2 points is going to win the set. Sorry.
I like that.
And whoever gets these next 2 points is going to show that they have the confidence to be able to
give them some momentum. As the DeWitt spike sails out wide, and it is 19-18 Hazlitt. Ott back to serve. Here's Kroner. Power, but blocked by DeWitt.
Hazlitt sets back up.
Holton tries.
Nice
placement
flying.
As DeWitt could not quite get that one back into play.
Has to get to 20. Let's see if my prediction's right here.
20-18. They have some momentum here. Let's see if they can build on that.
Ott serving.
Nice hit. That was a great set there for DeWitt. Oh, miscommunication between Rich and Holton, and it falls harmlessly right in between
them. That'll kill you. It's all about that defense.
A little momentum back on DeWitt's side. We'll see what they can do with their serve here as number six, Caitlin Setter, is back.
With the pass. set and spike. DeWitt saves it. Rich with a great save.
Oh, another little miscommunication as two Vikings converge on the ball. And it is now 20-20 here in the first set. We have our first stoppage of play. The Vikings are coached by Wendy McCann as the head. Assistant is Kevin Piper. Lauren Way is their manager. For DeWitt, they have co-head coaches, Christy Drayton and Ellie Hodger. I see a lot of other coaches over there. But
a lot of females
listed
on the bench,
yes,
tonight.
They have, looks like six coaches or helpers or something over there. And as the players
could be anyone,
up here.
I couldn't tell you who. Hazlitt student
here.
Section really showed up tonight.
Yes, they
and
are.
And a blackout, and you can really see the team spirit tonight.
Full force blackout here for the playoff match against arch rival DeWitt. These are always fun. Slater back to serve still as DeWitt has on a 2-point winning streak. Set for Holton. Nice hit. It is in. Great shot by Heather Holton.
Hazlitt takes the lead.
As we'll see another service try here for Hazlitt as they're up 21-20. Courtney Brassington back to take it. High set by Rich there. Set for Holton. It is down. Nice job there by Heather Holden. She has had two big points in a row here to give Hazlitt a 22-20 lead here in the early.
Hazlitt needs the momentum right here if they want to win the set. Looks like they have it.
DeWitt. Nice little touch there by number 14, Abby Knackfor, as Hazlitt cannot catch up to that slow ball. Number 8, Gina Villona. Back to serve for DeWitt.
The set.
Holton.
A bike
again,
is out of
nice
bounds.
Nice job by Heather Holton.
Has a point, 23-21.
Another stoppage of play here in the first set. Timeout DeWitt. It is 23-21.
It's getting rowdy in the Hazlitt student section.
We've got some noise coming from behind us.
I like to feel the energy in here. I like to think the Hazlitt team does as well. You got to give them a momentum booster.
Definitely.
When it comes to little plays like this. When
definitely.
They need two more points to win. I think they're going to do it personally.
I think they can pull this one out. If Holton, I think, has had the last 3 points for Hazlitt, she is on fire right now. And she will be back to serve.
Hazlitt coming out of the timeout.
Hazlitt is on their feet, the student section.
Great turnout.
Looks like they're almost back up to the wall here. And play's about to resume.
Not as good of a turnout. No surprise. So the home court advantage comes in.
Definitely. Holton sets it up. Looks like we'll get a soft over for Hazlitt. Number 14, Knackfor with the... Oh, the beautiful placement in the corner, and Hazlitt cannot believe it.
Hazlitt seems to be upset.
Regardless, it is 23-22 Hazlitt. DeWitt back to serve. Knackfor, who just had that great hit in the corner, will serve it.
Holton with
here's
the
Trasko.
Set.
It is in. Great placement as Hazlitt has 2 set points here.
This could be it with a good spike from Allison Rich.
And we got another timeout here for DeWitt as they need to regroup and figure out how they can get themselves back into this first set. Hazlitt is led by an experienced group of seniors. How far did they make it last year? Did they get to the state quarterfinals,
I
right?
believe it was the quarterfinals.
And they returned almost all of their players, if not all, maybe a
I
couple.
I believe they lost 2 seniors.
And so they are an experienced bunch.
Little
who
shot
are
of the Hazlitt student section for you there, right?
Yep.
Right there.
They are in full force tonight, making noise. Looks like we'll resume play here.
Hazlitt set point. Rich with the serve.
be big to get on the board here with the first set.
Great serve.
Pressure here for DeWitt. It's like a little conservative play there. Here comes Ott. It is out. No, it's in. Oh, the DeWitt player touched it off the block, and it is Hazlitt's point and Hazlitt's set. Great job by the Vikings to secure the opening set. It is 1-0 here in the early going. We'll have a set break.
That's going to be a momentum crusher for Hazlitt. For DeWitt, my apologies for DeWitt. Hazlitt's really going to get the momentum on that. DeWitt's going to be all sad.
We've got some Hazlitt students coming over here and messing with us.
Our apologies to the fans at home watching this. I think personally Hazlitt's front line is going to be that's what's going to win them the match tonight. Their front line shows up and they're going
to
be great.
They definitely seem to have the height advantage. And they've got the crowd behind them.
They really do. This is a very big, Hazlitt is now on their own student section side. They're going to get that whole momentum booster. They're going to get the fans are going to be rowdy. It's really going
to
help them out.
They should definitely look to get the crowd behind them here in the early going.
That's what the home court advantage will do to you.
Hazlitt certainly seems to have the height advantage. I see a lot of shorter DeWitt players trying to get kills, and it's not as easy on these tall Hazlitt blockers.
We're going to take a quick break. We'll be right back for the start of the second set.
It's all right. And that was a shorter break than we were anticipating, so we're looking to start play here again as both teams are ready. Looks like DeWitt will take the opening serve of the second set. Number 8, Gina Villona, back for the Panthers. Trasco to Brassington, up for Holton. Another big spike, but it is returned by DeWitt. Here they come, and looks like we've got a point Hazlitt. I think we might have had a net interference call on DeWitt. And Hazlitt takes the early lead and gets served back. Here's Courtney Brassington back. That pass gets over the net. Unfortunate there for DeWitt. And Hazlitt gets the point. It is 2-0. Brassington to serve again. Big block there by Hazlitt. DeWitt will try again. Set for Freund, who is seeing some action.
Speed tries to get it over and hits the net on it. She will not be able to get the point on that.
Another point, Hazlitt. 3-0 as they carry the momentum over from their first set victory. Freund over. Here's a chance for DeWitt. Big hit. Ott manages to save it, and it is, once again, it falls harmlessly between two Hazlitt defenders. That was a tough play. Maybe a tad bit of miscommunication, but regardless, very hard to get under that one as 14 NAC 4 back to serve again. 3-1 Hazlitt. Here's a chance for DeWitt. Harmlessly over the net. Here
comes Setter with the set on that one. Oh. There's a little bit of irony for you folks at home. Setter with another set.
Folks, I know you love it when Setter sets it. We'll make sure to point it out to you at home.
It's pretty punny.
Oh, Kroner with some power.
Woo, boom. Ooh. Goes the dynamite.
That is right. Setter could not handle that one. It is now 4-1.
She was swinging for the fences on that one.
That was the biggest kill we've seen so far here.
I think I burned a little hair off my face from the ball going by.
Definitely felt that one. Great serve there by Holden, and it's 5-1. They are pouring it on here in the second set. Ooh, in the net there for Holden. Didn't quite get under it enough, and it is, I think it's 5-2 for Hazlitt. Number 12, Steve, back to serve. Oh, Freund with a nice hit. Again, Hazlitt, the front line is really doing it right now. Taking it to DeWitt. It is 6-2 here in the early portion of the second set. Rich back to serve. Little touch over for DeWitt. Here comes Hazlitt with a chance. Great block by DeWitt.
Hazlitt not able to get the point at that one.
Not able to get it done on that one.
Hazlitt up 6-3.
Set here for Holden. Gets it over.
Out of bounds.
It is out. Point for Hazlitt. Not quite as hard hitting on that point, but still managed to get the job done. And it is 7-3.
To me, DeWitt seems to be more of a finesse team. They do not have the power. They're not looking for the hard hits. They're looking to get it in a spot where the players aren't.
Hazlitt definitely is looking to overpower DeWitt here in the early going. As that great block by the Viking front line, and it falls harmlessly on DeWitt's side. 8-3 Hazlitt. Megan Mowat, number 8, back to serve. We have a timeout DeWitt as they are looking to kill some of Hazlitt's momentum here. Speaking on Hazlitt's height, it looks like 9 out of their 14 players are 5'10 or above.
That's height for you, especially in high school.
Definitely, that is huge.
You see that in Division I teams, but very rarely high school.
They're looking that big. Hazlitt looking to have a strong performance here and look to make another playoff run similar to last year where they made the state quarterfinals in 2012. Here's Mowat back to serve. Ooh, tough return there by DeWitt, but they managed to
get it over.
And soft over for DeWitt. Here they come. Here's a chance.
The spike. Blocked. Great save
by DeWitt. Here they come again. Chance for Hazlitt. And it
is just conservatively
back over. Here comes DeWitt, number 13, Northern, with the nice hit. But the Vikings could not quite block that one. Number 5, Julia Rios, back to serve. Great play by the Vikings as Ott puts it down with authority. That was beautiful there by the Vikings. Great volleyball. It is 9-4 Hazlitt. Trosko to serve. Tell you what, Tyler, it seems like the Vikings are able to do a lot more with their serve.
They really do.
Wow, big hit by number 10, McKenna Ott, and she lays the lumber on the Panthers.
Student section got pumped up on that one.
It is 10-4, big lead for the Vikings. Trosko to serve again. Here's a chance for the Vikings as DeWitt couldn't do anything with it on that one. Holden.
Power serve. They barely saved that. Slater gets it over for DeWitt.
Here comes Holden again. Little touch. Able to be saved by DeWitt. Great play as Holden gets up again, goes back for Rios. Another block by the Vikings. And here comes DeWitt again. Great point here. It was touched by a Hazlitt player. So that will be point for DeWitt. Another great rally there between these two teams. Arch rivals.
That's the second time a point has been won because the player touched it when they shouldn't have. You hate to see it.
Setter back to serve. Big hit there by, I think that was Holden.
Great placement.
Excuse me.
You're excused.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
You're welcome.
That's what I was looking for.
So we're all
back to serve. Setter with the set. And we got a throw there on Kroner. Laughs it off. And it is 11-6 here. Hazlitt, number 8, Gina Villona, back to serve for DeWitt. Holden with some touch, beautiful.
That's finesse.
That was a great use of touch there by
Holden. Has a showing that they can do not just power, but also finesse.
They're
getting
they're
a little
showing
bit
a wider range of talents, definitely. Here's Brassington. Blocked, and Hazlitt tries. Great effort there by Holden, but she could not quite corral the Hazlitt block, and it is 12-7. Vikings with number 14, Nakfor, back to serve for the Panthers. Brassington sets up for Freund, and it is long.
Out of
much.
Bounds. That's going to be DeWitt's point.
Yep.
12-8 Hazlitt. Up 4.
Nakfor back again. Brassington for Kroner, who gets blocked off a powerful spike. Kroner with a beautiful block there. Heads up. The ball comes our way.
Ball almost hit me.
That was scary again.
I honestly saw my life flash
before me. Courtside, and we are in the definitely in the line of fire. Gotta be on alert as Holden back to serve. Little too much.
Once again.
Another service error for the Vikings.
The power's helping them, but it's also hurting them.
Yep. And that's
it's a blessing and a burden.
That's a trade-off you're gonna get when you play with.
Looks like they're hitting the weight room a little too much, Andy.
The amount of force that has it does, that's gonna be a trade-off you're gonna get. Brassington. For Trosco, big hit,
boom,
paints the corner, and it is 14-9 Vikings. That was a beautiful hit. Rich back to serve. A little spin on that one.
The set, spike, can't get it over, has a point.
A point for the Vikings as Rich is back again to send it off. Ooh, good hit there by the Panthers, and Holden could not quite corral it. It is Hazlitt up by 5 here in the second.
The winner of this game will go on to play the winner of the East Lansing Waverly game in the semifinal rounds.
Touch by DeWitt. Great save. Oh, and she is denied by the ceiling, as that was some great hustle there by the Vikings. Rich almost converted on that. Here's a set for Freund. Not quite high enough, but she's able to use that finesse we've been talking about to win the point.
That's all you need. A little power, a little finesse, a little win.
It keeps DeWitt on their toes. It
does. They don't know what's coming.
That's right.
Oh!
Clips the top of the net and falls in between all 6 DeWitt players. Mow it back again, up 6 here.
Mow it with the serve.
Nice hit, returned by Moen. Set for, the set just over the net, and DeWitt is able to block it down. That was a tough set to try, but it is 17-12 Hazlitt, as it's like that's Rios back to serve.
A little miscommunication. That's going to hurt Hazlitt.
Definitely something they can shore up if they're able to get past this match in advance.
That's the things you can teach.
Those are points that you are able to convert on, but are lost. The 3 points for the opposing team.
You can't teach intensity. You can't teach speed. You can't teach instinct. But you can teach those mistakes.
Another finesse play there by the Vikings as King finds the open area on the DeWitt side. 18-13 Vikings. Trasko back to send it off.
And it goes over nice.
Here's a chance for the Vikings. Holton.
That's a go
big
high.
Power. It bounces off the ceiling and could not be corralled by the Panthers. Point Hazlitt.
That's when the ceiling comes in unfortunate right there.
Yeah, that bounced all around. Bounced off three different parts of the overhang. Big serve. Number five, Rios, could not quite handle it. 20-13. There's your 20 points, Tyler. I think they can definitely win this one.
My prediction was correct last time. I'd like to think it's correct again.
More commanding lead than the last set, too. Hazlitt is on fire here in the second set. Up seven. Looks like if the Vikings are able to get past the second round match as well, they will face either Okemos, Lansing Everett, or Lansing Eastern in the district final to try and advance to the regional at Kalamazoo Central. If they win two games there, they advance to the state quarterfinals and will try and make a run from there. Trasko still serving, up 20-13. Nice power serve as DeWitt once again has trouble really doing much with the serve.
DeWitt.
There's Holton down and it is blocked by the DeWitt Panthers but out of bounds. Point for Hazlitt. Here's Trasko again. The Vikings are on quite the run right now. Here's King. And it is the attempted block fails for DeWitt. And another point for Hazlitt. This must just be crushing DeWitt's spirits here. Point Hazlitt on some troubling front line play there by DeWitt. The Vikings have jumped out to a 10-point lead. I'd be shocked if they gave this one up.
They only need two more to win. This could possibly be one of them.
Picks it off the ceiling. Blocked by DeWitt. Vikings scramble, able to get it deep, and it is out. Little too much.
Too much pepper on that one.
That's for sure. Vikings relinquish their first point in quite a few tries for DeWitt, and here is Setter back to serve.
23-14 currently, has it up. Backward set.
Ott tries to get the powerful spike. Was a little far away from the net on that one, and it...
Luckily, Hazlitt has a little leeway here. They have a little bit of room to make some mistakes, but not too much.
They can be aggressive. Setter again. Holton tries to be conservative on that one, but is denied by the net. DeWitt looking to get some momentum here. They have won the last three. Here's Holton.
Hits
looks like
ground.
It goes off of the pole sticking up off the net. And that will be DeWitt's point.
The boundary poles, I believe, is they're called.
Okay, good, good. I'll remember that for the rest of my life now. Timeout has it as they look to curb this 4-point streak for DeWitt.
Seconds left in the timeout for Hazlitt.
There's been a trend of not taking the full time, and it looks like that will continue as teams are breaking out of the huddle.
Hazlitt on a 6-point lead over their opponents. Only two more to win the set to be up 2-0.
Setter looks to continue the streak of DeWitt points back to serve.
Tips it over.
blocked by the Vikings, but DeWitt manages to get it back over. Big hit by Ott. It is down. The power once again coming through for the Vikings. And they have six set points here. They need to just convert on one to take a commanding 2-0 lead.
Set spike. That's all they need.
Here's Moen for Holton.
There it is.
Number five, Rios, tries to corral it, but she can't. Hazlitt wins the second set. It is 25-17.
We're going to take a quick break here to interview the national anthem singer, Patrick Harney.
Beautiful rendition, by the way, man.
Hazlitt up 2-0. Now, Patrick, how did it feel being the one singing the national anthem in front of all the fans out there?
Well, I thought it was really cool that they asked me to do that for them for the district game. I just hope it was a good luck charm for them. And obviously, they're playing really well, so I was honored. It's nice.
Do you have any nerves before you go out there and sing it? How'd you feel beforehand?
Oh yeah, I was really nervous because this is a huge game. I don't want to mess it up, and it's the national anthem, so people are just waiting for somebody to screw up. So yeah, I was definitely nervous.
How do you think Hazlitt's playing right now?
I think they're playing really well. McKenna Ott is being a stud as usual. Maria Cronin's playing really well. I don't know. I mean, all of them are doing really well, and they're showing DeWitt what's up.
That's great. How's the student section right now? What's the emotion like over there with all the students here?
Emotion's pretty good. People are excited, and they're happy to be here, and they're excited that our team is doing well. And it's a nice thing considering, DeWitt beat us in football Friday, so this is kind of our payback for that. So,
as a member of the football team, I can personally say that it hurt to lose. I want nothing more for this Hazlitt team to beat DeWitt and knock them out.
It hurt me to watch.
As a spectator.
Yeah, as a spectator, man. It didn't feel good, so this is nice. It's good for everybody. Good for the community.
That's great. Thank you, Patrick. Wonderful job with the national anthem. Thank you for being a fan of Hazlitt. I wish you luck in your future endeavors and your musical pursuit.
Thank you, Mihai, and thank you, Hammer. You boys are legit.
Hey, a little wave over to the camera. You turn over there. Little wave. This is Patrick Harney right here. Nice. Thank you, Patrick.
Looks like his head's cut off. He's a tall dude.
He is very tall. Right. I believe 6'7".
I don't know about that.
6'6". He's up there. He can dunk. I am sure of that. Patrick Harney for you, folks. Now, Andy, do you think making the move from Class B to Class A has affected Hazlitt at all this year?
Well, I think we'll have to see once we get deeper in the playoffs and see if that impacts the level of play. Definitely a harder league with more students at the school to play. So we'll see if they can make a deep run again, being in a tougher class. Looks like we got 15 seconds till we're about to start. Up the third set, Hazlitt looking to continue their run here. Here comes DeWitt. Big hit, it is blocked, but out of bounds. Point for the Panthers. It is 1-0 here in the opening set. Big for DeWitt to get that opening point as they look to try and get something going here. Down 2-0. Here comes Kroner. Finesse by DeWitt, it is out of bounds. Too much on the touch, and it is point Hazlitt. We are tied up. Holton back to serve. Came at the. Here comes DeWitt.
Just misses the ball on that one. It looks like she just tipped it. Didn't go all the way over.
Number 14, Nakfour, back to serve for the Panthers. Up 2-1 here in the early going. Trosco to Brassington, back to Trosco, and she puts it away. Great give and go there by Sarah.
Great spot placement on that one. She saw there was no one in the middle of the court, and she found her spot, picked it, and nailed it.
Allison Ritz back to serve as this set is tied early on.
Barely gets that one. Tips the net.
Quicks the net and falls harmlessly in front of the diving DeWitt players. Rich back again, up 3-2. Holton will harmlessly tap it over, and it is out. Couldn't quite get that one to fall on the sideline.
To be DeWitt's point. DeWitt's tied now 3-3. Has it up 2-0.
DeWitt makes a substitution as Setter checks out.
Has it looking to put this set away to get succeed in getting their win.
Comes Trosco, big hit. Paints the line, and it is 4-3 for Hazlitt. Megan Mowed in to serve. Oh, denied by the net. Number 9, Maria Moss, back to serve for the Panthers. Ott is up.
Great spike.
Nice defense by Rich. Here comes Trosco, just out. Ooh, deep. Oh, actually it was in.
It was in.
Wow. Another line painting by Trosco. She's on fire.
Questionable call by the line judge, but it comes out and has its favor.
That's all right with me. 5-4 Vikings. Here's Trosco. And that line judge has the best view in the house at that line.
That's going to drop, and that's going to be DeWitt's point. Unlucky drop for Hazlitt.
Finesse there by DeWitt as they tap it in between the blockers, who are looking for something a little more on that one. Here's Rios. Could not quite corral the serve. It was Trosco.
Ott's going to be diving out of bounds to try to save that one and not able to get it.
You can definitely see the heart here by the Vikings.
They want this more than anything, and they're going to do whatever it takes to get the win.
They definitely don't want the arch rival Panthers to pull out a win on their home court. It is in. Nice placement by the Panthers as they are jumped out to a 2-point lead here. Rios back to serve. They've definitely got some momentum now. Ott sets it up for Holton. Right in the middle of the Panther attack. Here comes
easy pass for them.
DeWitt. Chance here for DeWitt to convert off of Hazlitt conservative
block
play.
Gonna hit the ceiling. It's gonna help Hazlitt in this case.
DeWitt with another shot to put it away. Ceiling once again comes into play as Mullen could not quite clear the net on that one.
8-5, and it has a timeout. Trying to get a little bit of momentum there.
Big start here in the third set for DeWitt as they take a 3-point advantage.
DeWitt student section getting a nice little cheer going on. I'm assuming Hazlitt is about to rally.
Sounds like they're chanting something about football.
I believe they're saying, let's play football.
Oh.
Since DeWitt's football team sadly beat Hazlitt's football team Friday night. First round of playoffs with a score of 14-6. Some questionable calls that game. I was there. I don't know if I agree with them. A couple holding calls that took away a couple touchdowns that could have been the possible win for Hazlitt. I don't know if I agree with them, but there's nothing we can do now.
DeWitt football was number one in the division this year, so it was a big
10-0 currently going on to play Linden.
It was a great battle by the Vikings as they were able to stay within 8 points, which was huge. It was
Hazlitt being 6-4 on the year.
Here's Ott to serve. Oh, and DeWitt tried to get something going with a little running spike there, and it was rejected by the net. Ooh. As DeWitt with maybe a little miscommunication as the ball sails between two Panthers for a... Oh. Excuse me, I think that serve fell out. DeWitt will go back to serve. Number six, Setter, is now the server. Big hit by the Vikings. Powerful play here resumes as they are looking to come back and tie it up. Down 8-9, and Brassington back to send it off.
Steve with the set. Gets over to Hazlitt side.
Here come the Vikings as the ball sails into the stands off the block.
That's some power behind those.
Point for Hazlitt. DeWitt tried to block that spike, but it sailed out. And Brassington back again to serve in a tied third set.
Hazlitt with the block. Can they get it up?
Here comes Ott. Sends it over. Paints the line.
Once again, a lot of very close calls in this game. They're all getting them right on the lines.
Great volleyball. Great hitting.
Great game overall.
Definitely. We've had some great rallies. We've had some excellent spikes.
Off
oh, looks like the ceiling affected that one as DeWitt was not
expecting
it. Hazlitt
really with the home court advantage getting multiple points off the ceiling.
Definitely. DeWitt was not expecting that one to come back down on their side. That had the arc to get over. Holton to serve. Oh, nice placement and hit by number nine.
Trosco touches it, which is going to deflect off of Kroner, I believe. Maybe it might have been Holton. Deflected off of Holton. They were not able to get it.
Moss with a good hit. Knack 4 sends it off. Set for Trosco, blocked by DeWitt, and they get the point to take a two-point lead here in the third. They are
this
really.
This one's going to be a nail biter. DeWitt is not going to go out on this set.
They are fired up. They do not want to go home. They lose this, their season is over.
As a point.
Knack 4 with the service error.
A little too much.
Rich back to serve. Big hit by McKenna Ott.
Number two tries to save it. It's Maya Hansen. Tries to save it. Doesn't exactly go up. It goes across and hits the ground for the hazard point.
We are tied up here in the third. Great volleyball.
Too much.
Rich.
Rich.
Sends it a little long.
Someone's been hitting the weight room a little too much.
13-12 for the Panthers as Steve back to serve. Here comes Ott. Little long.
Booming.
And wide. Spike. Little too much on that one. It was a good set by Trosco, but Ott could not quite convert. DeWitt and up once again, up two. Nice placement by Brassington as number two. Hansen laid out for that one, but could not quite corral it. Moen will go back to serve, down one here in the third. Oh, DeWitt once again cannot believe the call on the sideline as another line is painted. Here in the Hazlitt gym, here comes Moen.
I don't know if there's going to be any paint on the lines after tonight. I think they're going to be wiped off from these balls.
Definitely. Here's Ott, blocked by DeWitt. They get it back up. Chance here, blocked by Hazlitt. Some great front line play here by both sides. Here comes DeWitt again. Blocked out of bounds. DeWitt point as they take a one-point advantage. The DeWitt bench is on their feet. They are loving this intensity being shown by their players right now.
Tied set.
Rich with the pass.
Here's a chance for DeWitt. Nice set. Harmlessly over.
That one goes high. Lit with the spike. Great pass by Megan Mowat.
Oh, nice set there by Rich as Holton sails it a little long.
DeWitt up 16-14.
That's that trade-off you're going to get when you hit it harder than anyone else. You're going to have some sail a little long. As Holton did not have her headband on that one. Here's a set for Ott. Some touch. Did not look like DeWitt was expecting that.
So the finesse comes in.
Definitely. Throws him off. Here comes DeWitt. It is in. DeWitt takes a 3-point advantage here in the third. I do not think Hazlett wants to have to take this one to another set, so they need to look to get something going here. Point for Hazlett. Strasco back to serve.
Hazlett chanting, you can't do that.
After a net infraction, I believe, by DeWitt. Here comes Holton. DeWitt will have trouble doing anything with this ball as Hazlett has another good chance. Here comes Holton. The touch and diving save by DeWitt. Good block by the Viking front line, and it falls harmlessly on DeWitt's side as Hazlett is right back into this third set, down one. Holton with some power.
Nailed it off the head of Charlie Steve.
Lays out, but cannot quite get it. Hazlett has tied it up here. They are at 17 all here. Powerful serve from Trasco. Here comes DeWitt. Two players once again converge on the ball for Hazlett, but are able to convert. Touch by DeWitt, gets it done. 18-17.
That was. Rios with the serve.
Here comes Holton again.
Another booming spike.
That's out as Nackford tries to tap it over on the run and could not quite get it in bounds. 18 all here as Ott is back to serve. Referees converged there for a moment. We have a stoppage of play here as the other ref comes over. Players look confused. Looks like unfortunately, we're not a ESPN, so we won't get an explanation on this one.
Sometimes I wish we were ESPN.
You know, maybe one day.
We encourage you to cheer, but you cannot make it personal. No use of names. Thank you.
Ooh.
Looks like there's some usage of names from either sides.
Getting a little personal here on Hazlett's floor.
The overseeing committee. I think they have to get involved now.
Not tolerated by the
MHSAA. It's part of the rule book. You can't do that. No one wants to see a steal or loser. Not what we'd like to see.
It looks like we've got net infraction from DeWitt, number 7, Alvarado.
Hazlett takes the lead. 19-18.
Timeout, DeWitt. That was an interesting situation. I think Hazlett's student section might have been getting a little too personal as the ref closest to them came over and talked to the head ref first. Interesting development here late in the third.
Ace, has the student section doing the Who's Your Daddy chant. Get the students going.
Hazlitt is on a 5-1 point run as we look to resume play here in the third. Ott will take the serve for the Vikings. Looks like DeWitt will have trouble getting anything with this one. Hazlitt's got a great shot here. Here comes the power.
Get
great
it over.
Job by, I think that was Kroner, as DeWitt could not block that one. The Vikings are 5 points away from a district semifinal berth. Here comes the power. Taryn King with the hit. Here comes DeWitt. DeWitt with another chance.
Set.
Here comes Holton.
Falling down with that one.
Great rally. Hazlitt is able to come up with the point.
Once again, my prediction, first one of 20. We'll see if it comes true.
We can make it 3 for 3, hopefully.
So far, I'm 66%, at least 66% of a minimum that I'm correct. Because I'm 2 for 3.
Excellent. I'm happy for you already.
I'm feeling the emotion right now.
Service error for Ott. Setter, the server. Here comes Holton again. Big hit. Right in front of the DeWitt defender.
She bombed that one.
22. That was a huge point as Hazlitt takes a 3-point lead here in the third and final
set.
Talk
about a momentum
swing. Actually, I shouldn't say final because if DeWitt wins this one,
they will go to at least a fourth set.
Service error again for the Vikings. Last 2 points, DeWitt has won. Has come on mistakes on the Hazlitt serve. Here comes DeWitt. Serving is Villona. Holton once again is a little long. As the last 3 points for DeWitt have all come on Hazlitt errors. They need to sharpen up here in the third. Here comes Kroner. Big hit returned by DeWitt. The touch.
Good block.
Then we got a net infraction on the Vikings, and DeWitt has come back to tie up the third set, 22-all. They do not want to be done with their season, that's for sure. They are pumped up, and Hazlitt takes a timeout. The DeWitt student section, not quite the same in number, but they are trying to fire up their Panthers.
There's a lot of energy over there, a lot of energy in here. And Hazlitt coming back with a chant.
Oh, Hazlitt with a we can't hear you chant.
A booming chant.
Go on the numbers of the DeWitt student section.
DeWitt seems to be speechless from that.
Yeah, they have.
Seems like Hazlitt called their number.
They have ceased to speak.
They have ceased and desist.
Hazlitt ready to play. DeWitt.
Timeout over.
Timeout here.
DeWitt using their entire timeout for the first time.
They are fired up. They are clapping coming out. They are ready to try and get this done as Villona is back again to send it off for the Panthers. Set for Kroner. She gets it.
Whoa.
Done. Big hit as DeWitt sails it into the stands after the failed attempt to corral that big hit by Kroner. Holton back to send it off for the Vikings.
Has only needing 2 more points to win the match.
Here's a chance for Hazlitt. It's for Trosko. She gets it done, and Hazlitt
point
comes away with 2 match points. Time out, DeWitt. Huge 2 points there by Hazlitt to go up 24-22. The Hazlitt parents are on their feet. The stands are getting rowdy.
This could be it for DeWitt. For the seniors of DeWitt, this could be their final point.
Looks like DeWitt has four seniors out of their 14 team player roster, so they might be looking to come out strong next season.
Hazlett losing.
Here's Holton back to
Hazlett losing eight seniors, twice as many as DeWitt.
They think this is their year. I believe so too.
I'd like to see. I'd like to see a state championship.
I think that's what their goal is. Here's a chance for the Vikings. The puck.
And they get it.
Hazlett takes the third set, 25-22, and they win the match. Big win for the Vikings on their home floor.
That is the game. Just like that, folks. 3-0, they go up to win the match.
Beautifully done by Freund on that last one to get it in the corner away from the DeWitt defenders. 3-0, commanding victory here for your hometown Vikings.
What an incredible game. I'm honored to be a part of this. The 3-0 match. You don't see them very often, especially when it goes to district rounds like this.
Again, Hazlett will go on to face the winner of East Lansing and Waverly.